So here we are in the research laboratory, and today in the lab, to give you an example, some example of some of the animals we have here, we have mice that we're using to find new treatments for human prostatic and breast cancer. We have mice that we're using to unlock the mysteries of Down syndrome. We have pigs with coronary arterial stents used to treat cardiovascular disease. We have zebrafish that we're using to find treatments for pituitary cancer. We have rats and mice we're using for gene therapy to cure glioblastoma multiforme. And we have dogs that have telemetry devices implanted in them to measure intraatrial and ventricular pressure to treat heart failure patients. This is Oreo. All our dogs have names. This is Red, this is Oreo, Raccoon. Raccoon's quite a character. Hi Raccoon, how are you? How are you, good girl? How are you? Hello, good girl. Our dogs get out to exercise and socialize twice a day with their caretakers and the other dogs. We have a toy rotation program. You can see that Raccoon actually likes this particular toy quite a bit. The best thing for dogs in a research setting is actually human interaction. And all of our technicians who are very compassionate about the animals spend considerable time socializing the dog. Something that is not discussed much, recognized much, is the amount of regulation that applies to the use of animals in medical research. In my opinion, and we have human subject research here as well as animal subject research, there are actually more regulations that apply to the use of animals in medical research than there are to the use of human subjects in human research. We must have an institutional animal care and use committee, a so-called ethics committee, that actually has public representation, scientists, non-scientists, and veterinarians with special expertise in laboratory animal medicine. No work can go forward with any animals unless a sound study design with justification and great detail is reviewed and approved by the Institutional Animal Care and Use Committee. And of course, that includes veterinary care, husbandry, housing, anesthesia, postoperative analgesia. Every detail of the protocol that involves the animal must be detailed excruciatingly in detail before the Institutional Animal Care and Use Committee will permit any animal to be used in biomedical research. We're sitting in OR4 in the animal facilities at the Cedars-Sinai Medical Center. This is actually one of our cardiac catheterization units. It's representative of the entire facility. It's clean, it's well maintained. The animals that are used here, of course, are anesthetized. We are very aggressive at Cedars-Sinai with regard to pain relief, proper anesthesia, analgesia. We have compassionate people caring for the animals. 50% of the investigators here, the scientists, are practicing physicians. They spend the majority of their time caring for patients, but they also carve out important time for research using animals to improve their ability to diagnose, prevent, and treat disease. They were highly regulated. The United States Department of Agriculture makes annual inspections. We are voluntarily accredited by the Association for the Assessment and Accreditation of Laboratory Animal Care International. We have a license from the City of Los Angeles to operate this facility. We are subject to unannounced inspections. We have outside community representatives who sit on our ethics committee who review in advance of conducting any research, any proposal to use animals. We're very proud of our facilities. And I hope that anyone viewing this facility will see for themselves that what we do here is very responsible, very humane, and very likely to lead to improved health care for human and non-human animals.